In the US, where some of the world's leading money managers are warning the collapse of another American bank could lead to a credit crunch and an economic slowdown.
And the US is bracing for a 10th consecutive interest rate hike as the country tries to fight off inflation. The Federal Reserve is expected to announce another quarter of a percentage point rise in its benchmark interest rate today.
What happens when 90% of the American population finds out that years of savings and investment into 401k retirement has disappeared? Calls to move away from relying on the dollar for trade are already growing. More and more countries, from Brazil to Southeast Asian nations, are calling for trade to be carried out in other currencies. The United States dollar has been king in global trade for decades, not just because America is the world's largest economy, but also because oil is priced in the greenback. Most commodities are also priced and traded in dollars. But since the Federal Reserve embarked on a journey of aggressive rate hikes to fight domestic inflation, many central banks around the world have raised interest rates to stem capital outflows and a sharp depreciation of their own currencies. On September 18th, American banking giant Citigroup announced the start of a tokenization service based on blockchain technology and smart contracts to be used for cash management and trade finance by its institutional clients. Known as Citi Token Services. It will transform customers' deposits into digital tokens that can be sent instantly anywhere in the world. This service is housed in the firm's Treasury and Trade Solutions division, which has so far focused on using it to improve cash management and trade finance capabilities. Citigroup is taking aim at the problem of moving money across borders, which can sometimes take days because of the myriad systems banks and governments use and differing work hours and bank holidays across the globe. We're also seeing other major banks take interest in tokenization as JP Morgan Chase explores a blockchain-based digital deposit token for speeding up cross-border payments and settlement. The company has developed most of the underlying infrastructure needed for the tokens, but wouldn't create them unless the project is approved by regulators. In a parallel development, the Federal Reserve Bank introduced its 24-hour instant payment service in June, sending a clear signal to other US-based banks to follow suit. Despite the attractive offers, being a part of Fed's insured bank will only give the federal government more power over one's personal finances. These significant strides in the financial sector are unfolding against a backdrop of intensifying concerns. The Fed's announcement of further increase in interest rates have sent shockwaves to the entire market. The very foundations of great corporations have started to crack as the dollars on the base lose their worth. For instance, the value of Treasury bills have plummeted down, taking major banks along with it. Most of the banks take customers' money, along with loans from other banks, and invest it in United States Treasury bills worth many times higher than the initial amount. They're levered up on the assumption that the price of these US Treasury bills will always go up. However, since interest rates are going up, the value of the Treasury bills is going down. We're seeing banks sitting on trillions of dollars of losses that they refuse to admit, while still borrowing against these Treasury bills. The catch is, they can't get rid of these. If they try to sell them now, they will incur huge losses and go bankrupt. They can't admit it too, as loss in credibility would cause a huge bank run. On top of that, people are pulling their money out of their bank accounts, moving it over into money markets where they can get higher lending rates. And as they lose more deposits, they get locked in. This is why they're borrowing more and more emergency funds from the Federal Reserve every day, showing their increasing desperation. At this rate, experts predict that several important banks are going to collapse. The most common cause of bank failure is when the value of the bank's assets falls below the value of the bank's liabilities, which happens because the bank loses too much on its investments, which can happen any moment. Not too long ago, the financial world was shaken by two of the most significant bank collapses since 2008. The Silicon Valley Bank, which held assets exceeding $209 billion by the close of 2022, marking it as the second largest bank failure in American history. Alongside it, Signature Bank, with assets nearing $110.4 billion, ranked as the fourth largest bank failure ever recorded. These failed banks had several things in common. They grew quickly using short-term funding before collapsing. Their assets were heavily invested in long-dated treasury bonds that exposed them to large losses due to rising borrowing charge in 2022 to 2023. And they had a large amount of uninsured deposits and other short-term liabilities that could be withdrawn at a moment's notice. Historically, bank failures have always occurred in waves. This means more major banking corporations are at huge risk for an imminent collapse. Once an unavoidable crash happens, all accounts will be forced to freeze, which means people won't be able to retrieve their deposited money. Americans are already struggling with inflation, food insecurity, and high mortgage rates. So this will be a major blow to their daily household life, reminiscent of the Great Depression. Now, some people may argue that the Federal Deposit Insurance Corporation will step in when disaster strikes. However, reality is not that simple, as they only insure money up to $250,000 and are notorious for taking weeks or even months to actually return citizens' money. All that is only to the extent of those under insurance. Moreover, the agency currently has less than 2% of the total amount of money it insures sitting in its reserves. This means that if all the money they are insuring was to go into default, they would only have approximately 2% of the required funds to cover those losses. This situation existed even before the financial crashes that occurred earlier in the year, so experts fear things have turned even worse now. The current economic conditions are having disastrous effects on the stock market as well, as stocks struggle this month due to the higher interest rates sending bond yields rising. The benchmark 10-year Treasury output has surged more than 30 basis points this month. In addition, during a period when trading is typically slower and less active, the market also had to deal with a significant increase in the price of crude oil. The market ended the month of September with major losses. Futures on the Dow Jones Industrial Average dipped 45 points, and the month proved the worst for S&P 500 futures, which was trading down significantly. The tech-heavy Nasdaq Composite is down 5.9% in September as growth stocks bore the burden of the sell-off, headed for its biggest monthly loss since December. The blue-chip Dow is off by a more modest 2.2% this month. Given the current financial challenges, it is obvious that the market is overvalued and that the assumptions behind stock valuations are unrealistic. And as the U.S. government issues more treasury bills and interest rates rise, the stock market is bound to become increasingly unstable. Uncertainty plays a significant role in investor mentalities. When markets become this volatile, it causes mass anxiety. One key issue during periods of volatility is the erosion of investor confidence, since shareholders start to worry about losing significant portions of their investments due to the unstable market conditions. As a result, they are led to panic selling, where investors rush to sell their assets in fear of further losses. Moreover, this behavior often creates a herd mentality, where many investors make similar decisions simultaneously, amplifying market fluctuations even further. When the stability of banks, government policies, and the overall economy is in question, it creates stress for investors who rely on predictability and stability to make informed decisions. Consequently, the whole economy suffers. However, mainstream media continuously suggests the opposite, ensuring people that business is booming, markets are great, and everything is prosperous. Experts, however, hold high skepticism about this approach, arguing that it's irresponsible to let oneself be deluded by these carefully tailored facts. They believe that this level of optimism is based on the unrealistic assumption that most companies' profit will significantly grow in the coming years, something practically impossible to happen with the current inflation and interest rate. By and far, most investment experts seem to agree the stock market is in a risky stage. Prominent investor Ray Dalio thinks that the economy is standing in phase 5, which is as the empire begins to decline and the debt bubble gets out of control. Furthermore, he says that the collapse of the Silicon Valley Bank barely came as a surprise to him. As the interest rates grew, the debt they held grew to be impossible to reimburse, forcing them to bankruptcy. He adds that this wasn't the only case of such predicament, as many firms have suffered the same fate, and many more are susceptible to this danger. As borrowing becomes more expensive, people are less inclined to use their money for relatively less needed things. This leads to a stall in demand, which cuts short the need for supply. Combined with the chronic labor shortage and rising dissent among the worker communities, industries are bound to suffer from large setbacks. Adding to the situation is the formation of BRICS. The coalition formed 5 countries, Brazil, Russia, India, China, and South Africa respectively. With China leading de-dollarization efforts, these countries are opting to trade in different currencies such as rubles and yuan, while trying to have the oil-rich Saudi Arabia jump the bandwagon. The alarming effect is the erosion of the US dollar's status as the dominant reserve currency. This erosion is indeed the correct term, as India emerges as the biggest buyer of seaborne Russian crude since Moscow's invasion of Ukraine more than a year ago. As Daniel Yergin, the vice chairman of S&P Global, notes, the recent escalation of the Russian conflict shows that the winds of globalization have shifted, and now, the United States and China find themselves engaged in a more assertive and competitive stance, which he calls a sharp power competition. As the world creates alternatives, continued disinterest in the United States currency is only further weakening its stance and shifting the power dynamic of the world. We don't know when the House of Cards will fall, though it remains unstable as ever. Comment down below on what you think, and leave a like if you find value in the content we do on this channel. Hit the subscribe button for all the latest updates, and we'll see you in the next video.